Hi, I'm Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to perform a quick static check on this Magnetek 505 or 506 series of inverters. Now, the first thing that we're going to do is make sure that the inverter has been powered off for some time. And if you're performing this check with it installed in its application, you'll want to go ahead and remove the UVW and the RSTs, or the input output cables. Otherwise, you're going to get a false reading. So after the drive has been sitting for some time, we're going to want to go ahead and measure across the DC bus just to make sure that we don't get any accidental shock. Now, on this specific inverter, there is a charge LED right here that, when it's illuminated, indicates that the DC bus is still holding a discharge. Well, this one's out. Well, let's go ahead and verify that it is completely dissipated. You want to go ahead and take your digital multimeter and put it on the DC setting. And you're going to take the negative probe and put it on the negative side of the DC bus, and the positive probe on the positive side of the DC bus, and take a reading. Well, it doesn't look like we're showing anything, so that's great. Now, I wouldn't proceed any farther if you had more than 1 volt. I would just stop, give it some more time, and then recheck it. So the first test that we're going to perform is a phase to ground test, and we're going to go ahead and move our digital multimeters into the ohms setting. Now we're going to go ahead and take our negative probe and find a good ground, and then we're going to take our positive probe and go between R, S, and T, and U, V, and W, and we're going to check to make sure that none of the phases are grounded. Looks like that's a good ground. I'll go R, S, T, or L1, L2, L3, and UVW, or T1, T2, T3. Well, that's great. None of them are grounded, so let's go ahead and move on to our next test. And we're going to be checking the input and output transistor modules. So we're going to go ahead and take our multimeters and place them in the diode setting. How we're going to be performing this test is we're going to be taking the negative lead and placing it on the positive side of the DC bus, and then we're going to be taking the positive lead and going between R, S, and T, and then taking a reading. So negative probe, positive DC bus, L1.42, L2.42, L3.42. Well, that's great. They're within the correct range, which is between 0.2 and 1 volt, but most importantly, they're balanced across all three phases. So now we're gonna go ahead and switch our multimeter leads and take the positive lead and put it on the negative side of the DC bus, and then go between R, S, and T with our negative probe. Positive probe, negative DC bus, R, S, and T. Great. Also, nice and balanced within the correct range. So we're going to check the outputs the exact same way. Negative probe, positive side of DC bus, UV and W, 0.38. Great, let's switch our leads. Positive probe, negative DC bus, UV and W. So amazing, both the inputs and outputs are checking just fine. So this drive is currently static checking good. Even though your inverter might be static checking good, there still could be a problem with the drive. And also, let's just say we found a problem with the outputs. Well, that doesn't also mean that there couldn't be something else wrong inside the inverter, and that's why it's important to have a full evaluation done by a credible repair shop. Now, if you need any more help troubleshooting your machine, please contact us at precisionzone.com, and thanks for watching.